Mail Plus High Availability ensures your email service runs without interruption by setting up 2 Synology nests in a high availability cluster. If the primary server goes down or requires maintenance, the secondary server takes over instantly to keep everything running smoothly. This reliability is crucial for businesses that depend on continuous email communication. In this video, we will show you how to set up a high availability cluster for Mail Plus server using 2 Synology nests. We'll cover the protection provided by the clusters, the required preparations, and the setup process. To wrap up, we'll simulate a primary server failure to showcase seamless failover. Before we start, make sure your NES model and DSM version are compatible with high availability clusters. Check the link in the description for a full compatibility list. Mail Plus High Availability safeguards your critical mail data and ensures uninterrupted email services. While it protects core mail components, it does not extend to data from other packages like Synology contacts or calendar. Mail Plus users can access the Mail Plus client once the primary server is back online. To get started, let's go over the necessary preparations to make sure everything's ready for configuration. There are 3 key elements to prepare: system and package settings, user accounts, and the network. Let's start with system and package settings. First, you'll need 2 Synology nests. Sign in to both using the same Synology account in Control Panel, Synology account. Make sure the system time is synchronized on both nests. Go to Control Panel, Regional Options, Time, to configure it. On both nests, open Package Center to install the latest versions of Mail Plus Server and Mail Plus. Choose one NES as the primary server and launch Mail Plus Server to start the setup. There's no need to configure the secondary server, as all settings will sync automatically when the high availability cluster is set up. For detailed steps, check the link in the video description. Let's go over some storage requirements. The volumes where you install Mail Plus Server must be the same size on both NESs. Make sure they're large enough to handle all your emails, as all inbound and outbound messages will be fully synchronized between the two. We also recommend mounting SSD caches on both volumes. These should be read-write caches configured in RAID 1, and the cache size should be identical on each volume. You can check the volumes and SSD cache sizes in Storage Manager. Next up, Mail Plus account settings. Here, we'll walk through managing user access and integrating with your directory service. Both of your NESs should join the same LDAP server or domain service, like Windows Active Directory. For detailed steps, check the link in the video description. If you don't already have a directory service, you can set one up using Synology Directory Server or LDAP Server, both available in Package Center. You can also secure the LDAP server by running it in a provider or consumer configuration. For more details, refer to the link in the description. Lastly, a quick note on licensing. Mail Plus High Availability setup doesn't need double the licenses for the cluster. It only requires one license for each user. Mail data from activated accounts will synchronize across both NESs. However, emails from deactivated accounts won't sync, potentially causing storage discrepancies between clusters when licenses are reassigned to new users. For user permissions, we recommend using the default permissions to ensure proper user access to Mail Plus. Also, make sure these settings are exactly the same on both NESs. Let's move on to the network settings. You'll need 2 static IP addresses on the same local network, one for each NES. Go to Control Panel, Network, Network Interface, and choose Manual Configuration. Make sure these IP addresses are not assigned using DHCP. Both should be on the same subnet, so there's no need to adjust the PPPoE configuration. For the HA cluster itself, you will need both an internal and external cluster IP. Let's start with the internal cluster IP. Choose an unused static IP within your local network, but outside the DHCP range. For this example, we're using Synology Router Manager. However, the user interface may vary depending on your router. In this example, we're starting off with a DHCP range of 192.168.1.2 to 192.168.1.254. We adjusted the DHCP range to 192.168.1.200. This leaves us with an available range of 201 to 254 to choose from for our internal IPs. In this scenario, we will assign the internal cluster IP to be 192.168.1.250. Remember this IP, you will need it later. Change port forwarding to direct traffic to this internal cluster IP. You'll need to forward the ports 25, 465, and 587 for SMTP, 143 and 993 for IMAP, and 110 and 995 for POP3. Use the TCP protocol for all of these and point them to the cluster's internal cluster IP. Next up is the external IP address. You'll need to get a static IP from your internet service provider. Contact them directly to set this up. The process may vary depending on the provider. Once you have the external IP address, register it with a public DNS server. You'll need to configure DNS records with your DNS provider. If you've already set up MailPlus, you're likely familiar with this process and can use the same DNS provider to configure the records. There's a link in the description with more information on DNS setup. We've now covered all essential preparations for setting up a high availability cluster. The following demonstration will walk you through the actual process of creating a MailPlus high availability cluster. Launch MailPlus server on the primary server. Go to Service and select Enable SMTP. For the account type, choose Domain Users or LDAP Users. This tells MailPlus where to get your user data. Local users aren't supported in a high availability setup. If you have been using MailPlus for a while now, please refer to the link in the description to learn how to migrate local email to domain or LDAP. Next, go to Server Management, Server List. Click Add to start configuring the high availability cluster. For mail system IP, enter that internal static IP address we reserved earlier for the cluster. Also, enter the subnet mask. Then, enter the details for your secondary server. Its IP address, the administrator username and password, and the volume where MailPlus server is installed. Click Done to create the high availability cluster. Once the cluster is created, you can click Manage to modify the IP address, subnet mask, or designate the other NES as the primary server. Let's put our high availability cluster to the test. We'll simulate a primary server disconnection and see what happens. After disconnecting the network cable from the primary server, we'll sign in to the secondary server. In the server list, you'll notice the primary server is marked as abnormal, while the secondary server has automatically taken over all workloads. This seamless transition keeps services running smoothly, showing that the MailPlus HA cluster is working as expected. To learn more about Synology MailPlus, subscribe to the Synology YouTube channel, or click on another video to keep watching.